What's up, guys? So today I'm going to teach you how inversion fair value gap works. So again, this inversion fair value gap forms only during your time macro time session. It means nagpo-form to during specific time only, okay? So if and only if nakapag-advance na kayo sa ating mentoring program, okay? So once na napunta na kayo dun sa part or episode, kung titingnan natin dito sa Google Drive natin. Okay, again ha, kailangan nyo na po i-download yung mga videos natin dito since mapupuno na yung storage natin. Okay, so again, kung napanood nyo na yung simula right around SB, obvious run, and internal. And then syempre may first silver bullet tayo dyan, okay. So, kailangan napanood nyo yung 29, 37, 38, and 39. Okay? So, bago nyo maintindihan to, bakit kaya, Sir Kim? Diba? Bakit kaya? So, we all know na ang silver bullet happens around 9:30 something. Okay? Creating to ha. Nagkikreate siya ng highs and lows. Pero yung mismong point of interest natin will be around 10 to what? 10 to 11. Okay? PM po yan. Philippine Standard Time, pero kung gusto nyo maging Amerikano, di ba? AM po iyan, okay? So, now, ito yung kailangan nyo bantayan. And now, between those 10 to 11, okay? Between those 10 to 11 din, same exact thing, doon nagpo-form yung tinatawag nating inversion, okay? Fair value gap, okay? Diyan nagpo-form yan. Around those levels, okay? Inversion, wow, parang napaka ganda tignan, no? Or maganda pakinggan yung inversion fair value gap. So now, ano ba ibig sabihin, di ba, ng inversion fair value gap, Sir Kim? Can you give us, you know, a little bit of example of this, inversion fair value gap? So now, let's take a look at this one, okay? So actually, kakagawa ko lang neto, okay, baka kasi mamaya mo nagli-leak yung Notion ko, so that's why hindi ko siya nilalagay kaagad dito, okay, nasa notes ko lang siya sa notebook ko. Pero, you know, I managed to get some time and managed to create a discussion or topic here on my Notion titled Understanding the Inversion Fair Value Gap. This is the, okay, kung makikita nyo dito, this is the powerful fair value gap like breaker block. Ano ibig sabihin nun? So, alam nyo naman itsura ng breaker block. Naturo naman namin sa inyo kung anong possible na pine-perform and may, for sure may idea kayo on how to perform the breaker block. Tama? Okay, good. So, now if yes, okay, ganun na ganun dito. So, now, Sir Kim, inversion fair value gap, okay? So, kailangan nyo rin makita guys na or maintindihan na itong inversion fair value gap is your first level of interest. Ibig sabihin, ito yung magiging unan yung sangkalan or unan yung side in order to tell kung nasa ng bias. It means, ay, wala pa akong order block, wala pa akong imbalances, or wala pa akong volume imbalance, wala pa akong order block na nakikreate. And now, possible, believe me, hindi mawawala na magkakaroon kayo ng fair value gap, tama? And now, yun yung magiging first level of interest ninyo. If and only if respected yan, then that's a good fair value gap. Okay? If hindi, now, Sir Kim, tama ka. Kasi way back before, sinabi mo last year or a year ago, sabi mo na fair value gap is meant to be broken. Tama ba? And yes, it is. And now, it will make sense kung bakit, no? It will make sense kung bakit. Now, ito yung tips ko sa inyo, okay? First and last tip for this inversion fair value gap you want to hear. Ibig sabihin, ito lang yung isa at panghuling advice ko sa inyo. When it comes to inversion fair value, wala na pong iba, okay? Wala nang iba. If the market closes above a fair value gap that you think should be a bearish, that's not a good shorting opportunity. It's called an inversion fair value gap. Naintindihan? So let's say for example, ganito. So let's say for example, the market is going down, creating, you know, market structure, change of character, and massively movement went down, then push the price higher. So, sa tingin mo, walang fair value gap dito sa mga songs na to? Definitely meron. Okay? So, as the price go higher and higher, may makikita kang ano? Change of character, correct? And what? Market shift. Correct. So, now, I know minsan hindi mo to kayang i-trade. not until master mo ang what? Breaker block. Okay? So once na nakapag-entry ka na dyan, you're good. And now, paano mo masasabi or kung hindi ka nakapag-position into these zones, kasi majority or 80 to 90% ng mga tao hindi nasusundan to or hindi nasasabayan to. Bakit? Fear. Takot. Okay? Takot sila. Kasi nga, less confirmation. Diba? So now, pero ito ay masasabi mong fair body gap, tama? Now, Sir Kim, ang fair body gap na to, bearish to, kasi nga, break of structure lang siya. It means, pag bumalik ang presyo dito, shorting nga, tama? Yes, correct ka dun. Pero, take a look at this one. If a market closes above the fair body gap that you think should be a bearish, that's not a good shorting opportunity. It's called inversion fair value gap. It means what? Take a look at this one. A weekly inversion fair value gap right around here occurred. Open above, which is not what? A good shorting opportunity. Open above the fair value gap. Not piercing. Not a top wick. Not a higher wick. Open above. Suddenly, went back to that zone. Went up. Opportunity to get into a trade. Target, I don't know. Volume imbalance. And maybe liquidity. Naintindihan? Now, let's make an example. Let's say for example, we saw a movement. Let's say for a gap. So, went down, went up, went down. The price is going inside of that fair value gap. Now you wait. If and only if it opens above, went back inside again, that is what you call an inversion fair value gap. Mag-iiba na yung pangalan niya, hindi na siya FBG lang. It will called inversion fair value gap. So in that case, you can delete the name of that one. And now, I want you to create a template named what? Inversion or fair value gap, kayo bahala. Okay, pagandahin nyo na lang kung saan kayo masasanay, no? So that's what you call an inversion fair value gap. Naintindihan? There you go. That's how you see an inversion fair value gap. Now, let's try to see and find some inversion fair value gap. Okay, so inversion fair value gap, sabi ko nga mangyayari to during silver bullet. Bakit sa mga silver bullets, ang dami-dami ng possible na puntahan, but sa silver bullet? Kasi ang silver bullet, it will give you 10 handles, okay? And now, kung hindi, or 5 handles, sorry, excuse me. If hindi sapat sa'yo yung 5 handles, this will give you at least 10 handles a trade. Naintindihan? So now, let's take a look. What time is it? 10, tama? 10, right around 10. You look for what? Between 10, there you go, between 10 to 11. Something like that. Our 11 will be around here. Between 10 to 11, dun magkikreate yung what? Tama. A silver bullet. Okay? Silver bullet. So now, na-trade mo to. Let's say for example, na-trade mo to. Now you went short. Take profit. Now, pwede ka pa ulit makapag-trade. Sino may sabing isang beses lang. Diba? So now, you look for what? Obvious run or take on liquidity. There you go. Take on liquidity. Now you have liquidity right around here. There you go. Oops. There you go. Now you have sell side right around here. There you go. Now, nasaan Sir Kim? Ang inversion fair value gap. Diba? Nasaan? Ano sabi ko sa inyo? Mas proven and tested po ang fair value gap kapag ano meron. Correct. Pag may break of structure and pinaka the best is change of character. There you go. Now, nasan yun? This one. Ibig sabihin, Sir Kim, dapat pala nerespekto and push the price lower. Tama? Tama ba ako mali? Bearish to, di ba? This is a bearish fair value gap or what we call what? CB. Sell side imbalance and buy side fucking efficiency. Pero in that case, ano nangyari? Tada! Open above. Now, yung fair value gap nyo or CB, papalitan ng pangalan ng what? Inversion. Bakit? It will turn out to be an inversion. And guess what? There you go. You have your position. Opportunity to get into a position, into that inversion. Naintindihan? And target those highs. How many handles? I don't know. Kayo magbilang. Naintindihan? Simple as that. Nangyari ang inversion during those time in between. Okay? Simple as that. Now, Sir Kim, nasa ng obvious run ito, liquidity dyan, ito ba yun? Yes. Okay? So, paano mo nasabi? Go to line chart, and that's an obvious run ito, liquidity. If you go back here, that's a very obvious run ito, liquidity. Created a what? Inversion fair value gap. Or, what you call, three driver, di ba? So, simple as that. There you go, guys. And now, since you have a little bit of information or idea when it comes to, you know, inversion fair value gap, I want you to take a look at this example of my gold trade on inversion fair value gap. Gold trade. Okay? So there you go. Between 10 to 11, I saw what? An inversion fair value gap. It's around here. Extend that. Ano sabi? Pag nag-open above. We did open above. Give you what? Position or sign of position to go long. Take profit will be buy side imbalance or buy side liquidity. Simple as that. Okay? So this will be your another assignment, guys. Okay? So I hope you can pass your assignment when it comes to inversion fair value gap. Napakadali na ito. Itong pinakamadali sa lahat. And I hope may matutulong kayo, okay, when it comes to this one. Okay? So, again, I'll be waiting. Okay? I'll be waiting for your assignment, guys, for this inversion fair value gap. Okay? So, since Kevin passed an assignment kagabi, no? I just check it. It's all correct. It's all fine. Napaka-clean or napakalinis talaga ng pag-plot niya dito. Right around here. So, yeah, continue that one, and now you can add inversion fair value gap to your favorite list of your strategy. Naintindihan? Thank you so much for watching. Hope you have a great day so far. I hope may natutunan kayo. Today is inversion fair value gap.